What's up, everyone? It's Copter here, coming at you with another video. I was looking high and low everywhere on the internet for a crazy story to talk about with you guys. And last week, I came across this story, but I didn't have time to get to it until now. This news story is about a restaurant owner who refuses to serve anyone who wears a mask. He actually went as far to kick a couple out of his restaurant because they were wearing masks. Man, you guys, this restaurant is pretty much the biggest meme right now, or at least it was a week ago. He's on the opposite side of the spectrum of most people in the world. All these store owners in states like New York and California, you'll get kicked out for not wearing a mask. But if you go in this guy's restaurant, you're gonna get kicked out for wearing a mask. I'm just thinking about the people who wore masks before 2020, man. All those Asian people, I feel sorry for them. Asian people specifically, it's the year 2016, it's 2017, it's 2018. You could walk outside and pretty much any day, go to an Asian community, see some Japanese or Chinese people or someone of Asian origin, and they're going to be wearing a mask. This was before COVID. There are some people who even wear masks to protect themselves against the sun too. I don't know, maybe this guy can take a different route on deciding who he's going to serve. Maybe you can just ask him who they voted for. What do you guys think? Instead of kicking them out because they are wearing a mask, he should have them seated after they fill out a survey. He doesn't even need the survey to be long. He can just have it be two or three questions. Question one will be something like, do you believe the government shutting down businesses and forcing people out of work is a good thing? Question number two, do you think someone with Alzheimer's is fit to run this country? Question number three, are you subscribed to Copter? If they answer yes to question one and two, but no to three, the restaurant owner will know to not serve you, and that specific customer is gonna get kicked out. I'm not gonna make a quick judgment and say this guy's an idiot without learning the full story, so let's take a look at this and try to make some sense of it. Obviously, the story takes place in the state of Texas. It seems like all the crazy anti-mask stories are coming out of there. I'm not saying all anti-mask people are crazy. I'm just saying some anti-maskers take it to extremes, just like some pro-maskers do. I mean, guys, there's obviously extremes on both sides of the table. But anyway, this restaurant owner in Rowlett, Texas has a no face mask rule. This couple visiting from the Dallas area, they have a little date night, hoping to relax a little bit, and they go to this restaurant. And guys, these two are parents and they're fully vaccinated. So I'm not sure why they're even wearing masks in the first place. Maybe because masks give the vaccine a booster. I don't know. You guys should tell me. It just seems like you wouldn't have to wear a mask anymore if you got the vaccine, because the vaccine's supposed to protect you, right? This couple has a 4-month-old son that is immunocompromised, which basically means his immune system doesn't work. And that's a very serious thing and very hard on the family. And each parent has the right to decide how to handle every situation how they want to. So good for them if they feel like they need to wear a mask, even though they're fully vaccinated. Good for them. So they go to the restaurant and one of the waitresses are like, hey, you guys need to take your mask off. This is very political, but this is a rule. So if you want to be served at this restaurant, take your mask off. This couple's obviously pretty surprised. I bet they're those people who stand in line for 30 minutes to get seated wearing their masks as they wait. Then they finally sit down and take their mask off, even though they have the same amount of area between them and everyone in the room at the same time when they were in the line. You know, because the thingy-dingy can't infect you if you're eating, but if you're standing in line, it can. So this couple must have contacted the news or something, you know. The article doesn't really say, but the news agencies contacted the owners, wanting them to know why someone was refused for wearing a mask. And I really have to say, you guys, I like this owner a lot. This is what he said. I spent my money on this business. I put my blood, my sweat, and my tears in this business, and I don't want any masks in here. The owner says that no mask is part of the dress code. Man, I really like this guy. I hope you guys like him too. Anyone going to Rowlett, Texas, visit this restaurant called Hang Time. Give them some business. This guy was probably someone who goes so close to breaking the law that you never really know if he does. I mean, stupid laws like this one. He's the guy in the theater who looks through all the garbages for that extra refill of popcorn that no one used yet, just bending the rules all he can just to get a laugh. And the only reason why he does it is because he can. You'll ask him why he dips his Oreos in water or why he wears his socks with his sandals. and it's just because he wants to, man. I really like this guy for standing up for something he believes in. A lot of very rich and powerful people who could have stood up to the government shutdowns didn't do anything, but we have small business owners like him who stand up for freedom. It's these guys who truly make the biggest difference here in this world. Anyways, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like and subscribe, and don't forget to tell your mom you love her before you go to bed tonight. Love you guys.